This is the result of a supply chain in crisis. Supermarket shelves in Perth stripped bare as the city lives up to its name as the most isolated capital in the world.
Now the shelves are looking a little bit bare.
About 80% of Western Australia's land freight usually comes via rail. But now, that's not an option. South Australia's record rainfall blocking major rail and road routes in and out of central and western Australia. Over 300 kilometres of the railway network north of Adelaide has been damaged, as well as key roads like the Stuart Highway, with trucks forced to take a 3,000 kilometre detour via Queensland to get food into the NT. Fresh flooding in WA also cutting off parts of the Great Northern Highway. In the meantime, these triple road trains, usually banned between South and Western Australia, have been given the green light temporarily to ease supply issues.
That will increase the capacity of the trucks moving from Kalgoorlie through to the city by about 50%. It also will save time, which is really important.
Meeting with SES workers in the flood-ravaged town of Port Augusta today, South Australia's Premier said there's still no timeframe for when critical freight routes will be up and running again, but vowed their repair is priority number one.
There is still an enormous, enormous amount of work that needs to be done by so many people as part of that overall recovery effort.
With entire South Australian towns still cut off because of floodwaters, authorities have ramped up supply drops. 11 plane loads have now made it to Coober Pedy, and 600 kilograms of food has just landed in the APY lands. The cut-off outback town of Oodnadatta is yet to receive any aid.
When you say how long have we got, we haven't. It's finished. We're out of fresh produce.
If the situation doesn't improve, WA officials are looking at shipping in goods as a last resort.
That's good. Ship can bring a lot of volume at once. That'll probably need to be maintained for a while because we're going to need to recover stocks and rebuild our warehousing in West Australia.
Aaron Fernandez, SBS World News.